Hey, ladies. Michelle here, Ultimate Mix Master Michelle. Scotty the Hattie. He's
Oh,
up
wait,
in.
let me do the Michelle wave. How do you do it?
Do not. I go like this. Hey, ladies.
That's good, right?
All right, do you need to scoot over here closer to me? Because I feel like I'm taking up this whole screen. Hold on.
I better.
There's Riley. Hey,
Oh, I'm around
Riley.
you.
How's it
Hey, Riley.
going? I'm in my comfy clothes and Scott's in his work clothes.
Well, yeah. You look
Yeah.
cute though. I like the sweater.
I know, isn't it so cute?
Yeah, super cute.
So cute. All right. Did you invite your girls when you jump on? If you're watching live, say hey. You're not going to see that though. So if you're watching the replay, say replay.
What's the deal with that, by the way? Like, why
What?
do you say replay when you watch it? Why don't you just watch the replay? Like, why do you have to comment replay?
It shows your support. And
Oh, okay.
hey, Riley. Okay, so Riley Peterson, Riley Carmichael was the one that was here.
Yep.
It won't let you? What? Let me see. See, I have invite. Oh, what? Doesn't it say share? Doesn't it say share at the bottom? It should. Oh, you got
Squirrel. Love that.
Hey, Riley, how's it going? Okay, we're gonna get this started because we got a good.
Past my bedtime.
We just put the kids to bed, so we got lots of stuff to talk about. But first, as usual, we're gonna jam out.
It.
Ready for it?
Get it.
I've been up all night trying to get there rich. I've been working on my shit. Missed the whole game twice. Gotta get it how I live. I've been working on my shit. Now get it work. Now get it work.
How long do you rock out for?
You know, my husband probably knows all the words to this song.
I can neither confirm nor deny that. I do like Iggy.
All up on my spaceship to Mercury. Turn first satellite, get in front of me. Cause every night I'ma do it like it's my last. This dream is all that I need, cause it's all that I ever had. Now get it work.
I love this song.
Good
It's
stuff.
like perfect.
Good.
All right, that's enough jamming out. I mean, I could have like jammed out forever to that,
That
but
was a lot of jamming out, more than you normally do.
I know because I love it.
Yeah.
Eggs, what? Okay. So, this is my business partner.
Business.
Business partner. And anyways, I'm going to talk to you guys about a few things, and then Scotty the Hottie is going to chime in when he's got the knowledge.
So like twice through this whole thing, I'll chime
Okay, so I'll let you know who I am. I'm Michelle McLennan. I'm the Ultimate Mix Master. That's what
Michelle.
I've been dubbed, the Ultimate
Mix
Mix
Master.
Master.
Michelle.
Hello, Sierra. I am on Bree Cahoon's. I'm on her first line. Bree Anderson is my crown princess. Kirstie Smith was my crown princess. I started in June on June 21st of last year. I am a royal. I am going for a ruler because, I mean, go big or go
That's
home.
right. I don't want to work anymore, so.
And Scott would like to not have to work.
I'm already doing the Mr. Mom thing, kind of, so I might as
He
well make it
is.
full time, right?
He is. So, okay, so I'm here to talk to you about your business, okay? Because that's what this is. And you need to treat it as such. This is an investment in your future, and this is a huge opportunity. So you need to treat it as a business. You need to stock your inventory and have inventory on hand. And you can do that with pre-sales. Okay. You can do that with pre-sales or pre-orders. You do pre-orders. For example, if you sell, like all launch parties, if you sell 5 collections, starter collections, which is a color, gloss, and an oops remover, you essentially are going to get in one additional color. Sorry, 5 collections, 1 additional color. You are going to have enough to place a 300 PV order. At 300 PV, for a lot of you newer girls, you get half off. I get half off at 750 PV. Every month I place a 750 PV order or more. Usually it's around 1,000.
Wait a second. What does that mean? How come you have to place 750 PV to get half off and then the other girls only have to do 300?
So these were incentives that weren't around when I was signing up. So they have what's called a fast start and a jump start. So there are a lot of incentives that come online each month, and they're just to give girls that extra push who have maybe been on the fence and who are a little skeptical about MLMs.
Sorry, I got you off track.
Yeah, so if you order 300 PV, you're going to get $600 for essentially... I feel like Scotty looks very professional.
Could be Riley.
I am the manager.
Okay. Yeah. Whatever you gotta tell yourself here.
No, really. He does like manage me. For real. Okay. So you're gonna get half off your order. So essentially you can turn that income back into stock. Okay, that is a smart business decision. You should be putting your income back into your business, okay? If you need it, if you need the income for survival, then you need to be working your booty off and selling, okay? And then take part of the income and pay yourself and take the other part of the income and put it back into your business. So it is very important to order smart. Okay, when I first started, my very first month, I was over 4,000 PV and placed 23 orders.
It's very frustrating.
Okay, do you know how much they charge in shipping and handling? Let's do the math. $350 for handling and $4 for shipping. So that's $750 times 23. Like, that's dumb. Yes, I'm calling myself dumb, but... You need to order smart. You need to place your orders, or you need to get your orders in, and you need to figure out when your orders have kind of halted from a party or from your launch or from your outreach, your follow-up with your customers, okay? You need to, before you place your order, you should always, okay, if you've got a party going and you have people commenting or you have friends that you know wanted it, before you commit to placing your order, you should reach out to all of those people. And you should say, hey, I'm placing my order. And I'm not saying post something on your page. You can also do that. You can post something on your page that says, hey, I'm putting my order in soon. But you also need to take it another step and you need to send them a text message, a messenger message. You need to call them. You need to reach out to them. Because the last thing you want to do is have a customer who is hoping to get something right after you placed your order and now you don't have it, or you have to go place another order and pay the $750 in shipping and handling. Okay? So reach out. That's going to be a good habit to form, because then it's also creating follow-up for you. So if every time you order, before you order, you reach out. Okay? That's going to help minimize your orders. That's going to help you get the most out of your money. Because also, if anybody wasn't thinking about it and they're like, shoot, she's going to order, this is going to be her only order, I better jump on this train or bus or whatever you're jumping on. Ship, raft, I don't know.
Any vessel would work in that instance.
Scooter.
Yeah, jump. Yeah, just, I'm going to jump on that scooter.
got my rollerblades on.
You use rollerblades on your scooter?
No, I'm saying... I ditched the scooter and I put the rollerblades on.
Oh, because that's what a person...
Because inline skating is cool.
Yeah.
All right. So, on to the next. Now, ordering can be scary. Every time I order, I consult this dude, and I'm like, what do I do? Do I do it? Do I do it? Do I do it? Listen, stock sells. It will sell. It is also a motivator for you to be a better salesperson, okay? And a lot of people don't like that word, but that's what it is. You are a salesperson, but you have built relationships with these people, so you're not really, you know, cold calling people. You've built a relationship. You can reach out to them, and it's not awkward and weird because you have a relationship with them. So it kind of takes that salesman aspect out of it. You're not a car salesman. You're now a friend saying...
What's that supposed to mean? Is there something wrong?
I mean, there's a...
Car salesman?
My husband is not a car salesman. I mean, he works in finance for a car dealership.
Yeah. Well, what I would say too, you know, when it comes to like the ordering thing, the reason that she brings me in, and we did it, oh my gosh, up until like, what, 2 months ago, maybe 3 months ago, she had her case with all of her inventory, and I would come in here, and I would literally like have to look in like 4 different spots in this little boutique that she has to try to figure out how many I've got and each color and all that kind of stuff. And it's crazy. If you want to simplify your life, keep an updated inventory so you always know what you have in hand. And the other side of that is every once in a while, Michelle would order a color when she first getting started, and she's got 6 of them sitting here. So it's important to hit that PV to get that discount, the biggest discount that you can get. But it's equally important to know exactly what you have in inventory at all times, so you're not, you know, way overstocked on one color and then barely have any of another color. You need to make sure you always know what's going on with that. Because as soon as you get that down, and I don't remember how you did it, but
Square.
There you go.
So if you guys use Square, if you need Square, I'm sure Riley Peterson or Riley Carmichael has a link. If they don't, I have one. There is a section where you can go under items and you can input every single item in the beauty book. And then as you get your orders in, you just pull out your order form, you check your order form against your product in your box, check your order form against the product in your box, because you need to make sure it's there. Now, I have never had stuff not show up, but I have had a friend who works another company have it happen all the time.
And it's like any other business.
Human error occurs.
You have to take physical inventory.
Yeah, and human error occurs. So always check your order form against the product in your box, okay? Then you just take your order form, you check it off. There's even a little line where you can check it off with the order form. You go straight to your Square and you upload it into your Square. You go find your product, you click on it, you say add inventory, you put how many you want. You can even put a tracker so that if you get down to one item or two items, like I always like to have 3 of everything in stock. So if you get down to 2 items, it'll say, hey, hey, lady, slow your roll. Next order, you need to order another one. And then just keep in mind, if you sell one of those items before you order and you've already started your order, you're going to have to adjust for that. You know what I mean? It's like if in between you selling an item and then going to order, you somebody else says they want it, you gotta be focused on that.
Well, and I'm assuming, I never see it from that side, when you order new inventory, do you go in there and you manually update everything, or does it do it through Square automatically, or how does that work?
No, they don't integrate with one another, so you have to, you go in, but it's much easier if you start off. I have not used that feature. Yay, thank you. Yes, it is amazing. Okay, we were spending hours looking at stock.
And when we did, you know, what's funny is when we actually put all that into the Square inventory, it took maybe a little bit longer than what we would do every month anyway, but it wasn't bad. But then again, especially if you're doing it when you're first starting out, I mean, if you're only putting in, you know, 300 PV worth of product, I mean, bam, it's just done like that. And then as long as you maintain it and stay on top of it, it's one thing. But I don't even want to know how much inventory you've got in here. How much do you think you have?
Inventory I have?
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, so it took a while.
Mm-hmm. Like $200, maybe.
Yeah, $200. That's totally what it is.
Yeah. But I would say to you, if you have Square, go get a beauty book, go sit down at your computer, and go through item by item and put the items in. Because at some point, you are going to order that for somebody. And when they go to order it, and let's say you're not sitting at your computer and they order it from you on the street, okay, you go to your phone app on your Square, because you can download it on your phone, and you say invoice, and you pick your customer or put your customer in there, and then you go to item. You don't have to sit there and type it in and be like daytime moisturizer dry. You know what I mean? You just go and you start typing in dry, and it pops up dry daytime moisturizer. Click. It's got the price in there already. You're set, rather than trying to fumble and figure it out. So that's another tip. Get your stock in order, ladies. Okay. How to stay motivated when sales are bad. There are peaks and valleys. He has to remind me of this all the time, because I'm like such a freak and a perfectionist that I'm like, I need to be selling all the time. Mm-hmm. All the time I need to be selling. All the time.
Well, and it's hard for a lot of people if you've never done something like this before or been in any type of sales world. This is all the same stuff, ladies. It doesn't matter what you're selling, whether it's cars or ATVs or cosmetics, whatever it is. Every single industry in sales has peaks and valleys. And I'm telling you what, I've been doing it for, 13 years now, mm-hmm. I think. I'm still not used to it. It just, but...
13 years?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
Well, I've been doing my job for 16 years.
God, you're old. Wait, so you think I've done it longer than that?
Yes.
No, since 05. I started selling cars in 05 at University of Motors.
Oh.
And then we met in, was it 05 or 06? 06, right?
05.
I have to look at your back. Anyway. But the point is that...
He says he has to look at my back. I have a tattoo of dates on my back, yes, and that's how we remember the stuff.
It's great in the summertime, especially.
How like, sad
when
is
did
that?
You guys meet? And I can just kind of like peek over. Oh, it was July or whatever it was.
23rd.
It was June, wasn't it? It was right after my birthday.
June 23rd. Yeah.
So anyway, so it's difficult to get used to peaks and valleys, but that's when you got to kind of go back to your core and go through the things that work for you. And
yes.
I've seen, I don't even know how many videos are on there. I mean, this is a very hot topic right now because it seems like everybody has been in a bit of a lull, which I'm assuming is why they had those great incentives last month and all that kind of stuff.
Well, December's
everything
hard.
Is slower in the winter.
Yeah, December's hard. Everybody's like, oh, everybody's going to buy stuff for Christmas, but they already have stuff picked out for the people. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, mm-hmm. It's hard to buy a lip color for somebody. That's hard. Like, what would I pick for my friend? I don't know. Because I'd probably pick a wild, crazy color, and then she would never wear it. And then I'd be like, oh, gosh, then I shouldn't pick a wild, crazy color. I'll pick something. Okay, we're getting off topic. Anyways, that's my insanity. Listen. So, peaks and valleys. Don't get down on yourself. Just reevaluate, okay? When you start to have a lull, you need to reevaluate. You need to stay consistent, though, throughout that. Don't just give up and be like, nothing's working. I just give up. I'm not good at this. Okay, nobody's good at anything. You can always be better at everything, right? So when you first start out, you're not good. Like, I was not good at lives. The first video that I did of a live, I thought I was going to hyperventilate. And, like, I was fighting the tears back. And I kept doing this number. And I'm like... I'm going to sell.
You said,
Yes, I'm like, 300 times. I'm going to sell.
We should go back and watch that video because that would be
hilarious.
We should.
I'm going to sell. I couldn't even, I'm like, I was nervous about it. I kept putting it off. I kept procrastinating. I'm like, so I am addicted to Vaseline. And I kept talking about it. And then I was like, and then finally I was like, okay, in my mind, I'm like, I got to do it. Okay, now I go live 3 to 4 times a week. I love it. People love it. People love to hear what I'm doing. They love to see what I'm doing. They love Matilda. They love Scott. They love Bugsy. I mean, Bugsy's a three-nager right now. So
nobody loves Bugsy.
We kind of keep him away from the camera because he just yells a lot. But but yes, we love Bugsy. He's just an a-hole sometimes. It's okay. Well,
he's better, though. It's like 10% a-hole. Last year, it was like 80% a-hole.
Yeah,
so
it's okay.
Way better.
When you have kids, you'll understand. It's okay to call your kids a-holes.
Yeah.
That's okay.
It's totally okay.
So people get excited. So find what you're good at. You might not be good at lives. So what? You might be good in person. Get yourself an in-person demo. See how it goes. Okay? You might be good at groups of people. Get yourself a party. See how it goes. You have to find what you're good at. Maybe you're great at taking photos of your lips or your face or a product, or maybe you're great at flat lays where you can pick an outfit and put a color with it and get people excited about it.
Hey, you're literally great at all of those things.
Oh,
pretty badass. I'm great at compliments.
He's so great. Yes, he is. Okay. So don't get down on yourselves, okay? Reignite the fire by reevaluating what you're doing and what's working, and pay attention to what's working. Pay attention to how many likes you get, how many views you get, how many comments you get, how many people reach out to you. Pay attention to that, okay? What to do? What do you think is going to take to get you to the top? What do you think, babe?
Well, that's a pretty big one. I have been pretty much with small businesses my entire adult career. So I've seen the struggles that a small business can go through. Shoot, I was raised in a household that had a small business. I've done a startup before. I've done companies that have bought other companies. So the big thing is it's not going to be easy. Don't kid yourself into thinking that in order to reach a really high level of success, it's just going to be handed to you. And you can just lay back on the couch and, you know, do a Facebook Live once a week and text your friends and you're going to be a millionaire. That's just not the world we live in. But if you look at the girls that have been super successful with this, they're all hustlers. They're out there trying to do different things. You've got to get out of your comfort zone. That's a big thing. Like if you're afraid of doing something, then maybe just try it a couple of times. Mm-hmm. If Michelle never would have went through those lives and freaked out through the first couple, then she wouldn't be where she is right now. Mm-hmm. You always have to change. You always have to evolve. And you've got to figure out angles, ways to get people interested in this kind of stuff. And if you're passionate about it and you like doing it, then it gets easier because it's fun for you, you know. But I mean, every time Michelle goes out, she's wearing her product. That's a huge thing, which I really appreciate that, especially the lipstick. But every, you know, and it's always, you know, different colors, and you would not believe how many people come up to her and, you know, ask her about, oh, I love your lips. What color are you wearing? And all that kind of stuff. You know, I've got to like, okay, you know, get away. All right. It's taken, you know, that kind of deal. But
oh my gosh. I'm sorry. I'm not even paying attention to you. Yeah.
I should have rammed a little bit farther.
I was reading Riley's comment. The people who love you and love the product will always support you no matter what, no matter your small struggles.
Oh, that is one thing that you're not good at, though. You can't read a comment and keep talking at the same time in the video. You always have to stop to do
Thanks. He had to take me down a notch. You see that? He felt like he gave me too many compliments. Exactly. And he was like, hold up.
Yep.
I feel like consistency is key. And yes, find somebody who is successful in this business and duplicate what they're doing.
Yeah.
You mimic what you want in life.
Yeah, don't be afraid of that too. So many people are afraid of, oh, well, it's her idea. I don't want to take it. You're not taking an idea.
You have a whole different audience.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, if somebody's using something you think it might work for you, then try it out. How many ideas have you got from Brianna Cahoon, Brianna Anderson, all the other girls that are in your groups and everything? I mean, Michelle focuses not on just her uplines, but her downlines as well. I mean, she'll take a good idea no matter where it comes from. And that's a big thing as well. Don't be afraid of that kind of stuff. I mean, if you find something that you think is going to work and some other girl's using it, well, obviously she's having success with it. So don't let it slow you down. Use it.
Right. Use it. Make it your own, but use it.
Yeah.
So, yes, I think if you ladies are consistent and you're passionate and you're really striving for success, you're going to be successful. You have to think that you're going to be successful, okay? You have to believe in yourself. You have to find what keeps your interest and you're passionate about. Because if you lose the passion, people will see that instantly. You've got to continue to nurture your business and be passionate about what you're doing. So if you ever feel like it's getting repetitive and you're doing the same thing and you start to get into that, like,
funk.
You need to change it up, sister, fast. Because if you are going live or you're meeting with people and you're in that funk, they're going to see it and they're going to stop buying from you because you're not passionate about it. So get passionate, stay passionate, follow the people who inspire you, follow the people who have impacted you in a way that you are always, when they pop up, you know who that person is. Your vibe attracts your tribe. So you've got to stay positive. You've got to stay consistent and you have to stay passionate. And when you think it's hard, you need to push right through there. Mm-hmm. You need to push right through. You need to pick yourself up and go do a live and get happy about it. Sometimes I have a beer or two before I do a live because I'm like, I am in a funk. I'm tired. let's, okay, I'm not saying go get drunk.
Yeah, so that's probably not like the best thing, you know.
I'm just saying I got to pick myself up a little
bit. I mean, yeah, we're both drinking right now, so, I mean, you know.
We're not saying we're not excited to be here. That was a bad example.
We got full-time jobs. I mean, you know, we got to have a drink.
Yeah, that was a bad example. Sorry.
Yeah.
What I'm saying is pick yourself up, get it done, and by the time you get done with it, you're going to be like, that was awesome. Let's do it again tomorrow.
Yeah, okay? It's a rush. It's cool to see that. Like, Michelle will have funks like anybody else, but then when she has like a really successful live or something happens, I mean, like this, like the energy, like
she's, I'm like running around the house. I'm like, $600.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. It's hard to sleep.
So where is my journey going to take me? We all, you need to ask yourself that, and you need to visualize that, and you need to think about what you want out of this, because you need to envision it and imagine yourself there. Okay. Imagine yourself a crown princess and imagine your team of people who adore you and are inspired by you and who look up to you and who want to be you. Think about that and envision yourself in that position. And you will be there. You will be there. Believe in yourself. Get it done.
Get it done. That's right. No excuses. It's going to end the day here.
All right, ladies. I hope that helped you out. Let me know if you have any questions. If you're watching the replay, thank you. If you're watching the live, thank you. All right, ladies. Thank you, Riley. Have a great night.
Stay bright.
Stay bright. Oh.
Still going? Yeah. Are we still here?